All right, on by invitation, we're talking to Dr. Billy Quek this morning, master trainer and international motivational speaker. Topic of discussion that we're having is live by design, not by default. We are taking in your questions, and we have one from Maryam.
My frustration. I'm a school teacher, Sarah.
Yes, I know that.
School teacher.
Yep.
And I've been given the task to teach English to the students and the teachers, but I seem to be, against the wall because they're not native speakers, and I have trouble even getting through to them, even on a special day, like one day a week, we put all languages aside, just English for today. I can't get through, and I'm really, really frustrated because I have a passion for English and I teach English. But what I seem to understand is that they're not interested. How do I make them interested? I've been to training programs and, like you said, coaching program, but I can't get through.
Okay, well, thanks for your call, Maryam. Billy, any advice?
Okay, for one, perception is projection. So if you're harboring frustration inside, then I think you're going to be projecting it, and it's very unlikely that you will get a response. So let me clarify the two words. Reaction is negative, responding is positive.
Right.
There's different strategies you can use, although some are generically more effective than other methods. So start with inspirational appeals. Go with the positive approaches. All right. Find out what lights their fire. If the kids are not speaking English, then what are they speaking? How did they get good and how did they enjoy those other languages they're speaking?
Right.
Because if you discover what motivates them to use those other languages more, then you can instill the same strategy inside.
Right.
Try different approaches. Pull, push.
But it's not, I mean, so she might not be able to, what motivates one person might not motivate the rest of the class.
That's right.
So it'd be very specific then.
Yeah. So like I say, I think motivation has got no blanket approach, although right. some mm-hmm. method seems to be more effective
right.
when you are applying it in a general mm-hmm. group situation like inspirational appeals. So with some different individuals just respond differently. Some of them get motivated when you encourage. Some people you just have to pressure them. And then they get encouraged.
Okay, but here's maybe this is what is also a bit of a problem. So the school kids might be living by default from what their parents
yeah.
are teaching
mm-hmm.
them to do.
Mm-hmm.
So that when they get to school and Maryam is there saying, hey, speak English, they're going, I don't speak English at home.
Mm-hmm.
Why should I speak English with you?
Mm-hmm.
That sort of thing. Would that be an issue as well?
Yes, it will be.
Like clashing of the, you know, of the ways that we live.
Yeah, but I think kids are also learning and they're highly adaptable. They do realize that, you know, back at home I'm different, I behave different.
Right.
Rules are different coming
right.
to school, the rules are different.
You got a point there.
Yeah. So they're smarter than we think they are.
Yeah.
Actually, Richard was saying, you were saying that about your daughter, right? She's one way at home, but when she's at school, she's
behaved. Exactly. At home, she's a completely different person.
Right.
And when she's at school, yeah, like you said, she's like an angel.
Well, right.
So I was quite shocked, actually. My girl can actually learn to be
well-behaved.
Yeah.
She has learned something at home.
But is it to every teacher in school?
Yes.
In every situation in school?
Most teachers, I think,
kind of like adjust itself
to the teacher
and it responds differently to the teacher.
Yes,
the point
to
I'm
the
making
teacher
exactly.
And how they actually,
So here's another principle we teach in NLP, because a part of which is about enhancing relationship. It's about building rapport. People like people who are like themselves. When you are like each other, you like each other.
Right.
So really my message, because when I look back during my school days, why is it that my English sucks? And it's true. I got F9 for English twice.
Wow.
For my O levels.
That's kind of hard to believe.
Equivalent to your SPM here.
All right.
But if you look at my teacher, he's really not that attractive. Especially for a visual teenager boy, you know. But I did really well on my Chinese.
Right.
My Chinese teacher, Madam Chua, is the most beautiful teacher I've ever seen in my life.
Right. So
I like her already. And
yeah.
I want to do,
so
I adapt my behaviors to please her. Yeah.
Right.
So I think people like people who are like themselves. Get to the kids. Starts with the teacher. Build the rapport and the relationship at an individual level so that they see the need and they want to please you, they want to oblige you, they want to work with you.
Right.
And then together you can drive the speaking English thing.
That is a very interesting point. We've got more about children when we come back, Richard.
Okay. On by invitation, talking to Dr. Billy Quek, master trainer and international motivational speaker, talking about living by design, not by default. If you have a question you want to post to Dr. Billy Quek, feel free to call us 0395433333. Or if you have a comment you'd like to say he speaks very well, also call us and tell us about it. Or you can put it on Facebook, FB.LightFM.com.my. Tuesday morning on by invitation, talking to Dr. Billy Quek, master trainer and also international motivational speaker. Live by design, not by default. And we've got Vincent on the line.
For me, the learning is not by design. Especially the teachers, right? Basically, it's an art that should be learned by teachers. See, most of the teachers or people who are teaching always jump into teaching by default and say, this is how you should learn.
Right.
For example, I'm a teacher and a lecturer for 20 years.
Okay.
All right? I go into my, university class and I tell them, I try to attract them. The way I attract them is say, anybody who is a Manchester United fan, you fail. I say, you better learn to support Liverpool, you know.
Oh, say, no.
They want to impress me. They want to say their team is good. And I bring in my subject around that.
Okay.
So I learn how to design teaching based on students' interests and how to learn their interests. It's an art.
That's a good point. But how long did it take for you to learn something like that, Vincent? Quite a while.
I'm learning. I'm still learning.
Still learning, huh? Still learning. We never stop learning. Yeah, Billy, what do you got to say for Vincent?
I think what Vincent shared is a very good example of how he has taken charge to teach by design.
Yeah.
And if teaching is a part of his life, then he's really living by design in an instance.
Right.
The thing, though, it's... I think we can always take charge in different situations. It's a matter of choice.
Right.
All right. When we say no choice, we've made a choice. And that shuts out all the options and then we stop exploring.
Right.
If it's possible for someone to do something, it is possible for you to learn to model it and do it as well. All right. So if someone is tremendously successful in getting the students to listen to them and follow them and listen to what they have to teach and all that without questions, just loving it, right? Uh-oh. Like everything this particular teacher says is gospel truth. Then this particular teacher has done something right that we can learn from.
Right.
Okay. So back to us as individuals, regardless of what we're doing, whether you're teaching, you're selling, you're a leader, you're a parent, take skills inventory. Find out what is it that you need
skills
that will enhance.
Inventory.
There you go. Take stock. What do you have that will then allow you to do the things? What are you not able to do? And then what can you learn so that you can do them? And check yourself. What is it that you do that even on your worst day, you do it better than other people on their best day? So that becomes a strength zone, and I think we need to hone that further.
Uh-huh.
All right. So discover what lights your fire within yourself. Discover what are the innate talents in yourself.
Right.
And then hone them further. Develop the weakness area and become more complete, more wholesome.
That's a good. It's a good point. But so what you're saying is, you know, Billy, if we want to live by design, then we have to be open to relearning, even at like Richard's age and
learning creatively.
Relearning.
I wrote a quote one time. It says, "Learning should never cease, so that living never stops."
Right. Okay.
Every time we learn something new and we go back to the same circumstances and situations in the job, we would do it differently.
Right. Yeah. Okay. That's good, Richard. So you need to relearn a couple of things, maybe about, you know.
Why is it always?
No, I'm just thinking. Yeah, thank you, Billy. Oh no, I was just thinking,
I got to protect my own kind, you know.
All this is leading to success that we're talking about. Anything that you're doing, but if you want to coach children to be successful, I mean, how do you do
that? Think it's a little bit tougher?
First off, define success. Different people define them differently.
Yeah.
So we got to find out what is success to these kids. And my take to the control freak parents out there, they're only a child once.
Right.
A 3-year-old must behave like a 3-year-old. If he behaves like a 13, please be worried.
Right.
Yeah. Right. So I think a lot of times you're trying to make them grow up too fast by imposing on them.
Yeah.
I feel that we ought to just expose them to different things. You know, building fundamental moral values and ethics, the foundation, and then leave them to explore. Understand what they want, understand what they're looking for, open up the options for them and be there to support.
That's the thing, Billy. Explore what they want. Just an example, my kid. What would you like to be when you grow up?
I want to be a nurse, Daddy. Why don't you be a doctor? Doctor is the one making the money. Why do you want to be the nurse?
Nurses are prettier.
Parents try to make their kids live by default.
That's what I mean.
I would say we make them live by default, but if they follow what we dictate them to do, then they live by default. Yeah. So the result is that we get professionals, be it teachers, doctors, who are actually not passionate on the job. They actually don't enjoy what they're doing.
Exactly. Right. There's a lot.
So if they are not enjoying what they're doing, they're carrying around all these negative emotions and beliefs. how well can they do the job?
Good point. Dr. Billy Quek in the studio with us on my invitation this morning, master trainer and international motivational speaker. Live by design, not by default. Still got time to take up all your questions. 0395433333 if you have one. Or you can put it on Facebook, fb.lightfm.com.my on the light break.